get it now.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Scott. For the second time in a couple of months, environmentalists are putting fear into the hearts of fishing communities. Last fall, a group of environmentalists threatened to sue to stop steelhead fishing in Idaho. The suit said federal fishery managers have failed to approve a plan to manage steelhead. Negotiators were able to keep the season alive, but now the government shutdown has some saying the spring season may be in jeopardy. Steve Liebenthal explains in tonight's Idaho Backroads.
The latest controversy started when the Idaho Conservation League discovered NOAA fisheries managers who are supposed to be working on Idaho's steelhead plan are on furlough. So Director Justin Hayes wrote a letter to Governor Little. The letter says Idaho's permit application is sitting on an empty desk in an empty office, putting river communities at risk. The letter concludes by asking the governor to ask the Trump administration to prioritize getting federal fisheries managers back to work. But will that happen? And if not, will the season really shut down? One thing is for certain. With the exception of a couple of stretches of river, steelhead season is open in Idaho until at least March 15th. But ICL says the government shutdown is a concern.
With these government employees not able to work on this, it could potentially reshut the season down again in the spring.
People are catching fish.
Bill Mock, a Boise attorney who represents the Idaho River Community Alliance, says he's not worried.
I don't think anybody should panic at this point in time. We're open for business up in Riggins and Lewiston and Orofino, the restaurants and the bars and the motels and the tackle shops and the fishing guides are all ready to serve you. And for the next 60 days, we've got a firm agreement that fishing season's open for steelhead.
Mock was one of several attorneys who helped negotiate the deal that kept the season open after environmentalists threatened to sue to shut down fishing in Idaho. He says an extended government shutdown would cause some concern, but he doesn't believe steelhead fishing will be halted.
We developed a really good working dialogue with all these interest groups, and I'm optimistic that if something like that happens, it's beyond the control of any of us. That we can come back to the table and open up negotiations again and see what we can do to extend the season.
Even one of the main players in the original lawsuit says he doesn't believe the shutdown will stop fishing in Idaho. He declined to speak on camera but called the letter grandstanding. Deutschman herself admits that the notion of President Trump prioritizing river communities in Idaho may be naive, but she says it's important for our governor to take this issue seriously.
Some kind of attention would be better than nothing, because that would hopefully then motivate people to take this issue seriously.
To bring more attention to the issue, the Riggins community is holding a rally and celebration of steelhead this weekend. It will involve